Hey guys, it's your girl, Brittany Alexandra. Welcome to a new series brought to you by Remy Martin called Toast Up. We'll be talking with your favorite celebrities, music artists, social influencers, and more about the questions that matter most, and also get into some juicy hot topics.
Hey,
we're going to have to put this thing on repeat. Hey, Ade, what's good, brother?
What's up with it?
Welcome to my world, first of all.
Yeah. How's it going? I appreciate you having me.
Of course. First of all, cheers. I got my drink in my cup. I saw you drinking too, right quick.
Yeah.
Cheers.
Oh, yeah. You know, I'm all the way good over here.
Oh, okay. Look, I got that too. We're going to pour up for all the homies.
Big Remy. Toast to you.
Look, all of that, okay? Ade, first of all, I got to say, because literally nowadays, I feel like I need a drink every day, bro, because this pandemic is something very serious. How have you been navigating during this time?
You know, I mean, it's been a lot different because all the night spots are closed. The places to do concerts are closed.
Yes.
So I've definitely had to, like, figure out a way to still perform and touch people without actually touching them.
Yeah, exactly. I was about to say, you definitely love the nightlife. You know, I've seen you out and about in the DMV. Shout out to Maryland. Yeah. You know, shout out to DC. We see you. And like you said, you can't be out and about with people. And I understand that because I love that energy of being in one another's presence. So this time's kind of allowed us to slow down a little bit and to learn more about ourselves. So what's one personal focus you've been kind of tapping into in the midst of this weird pause we're kind of being able to experience right now?
Man, so, you know, being trapped in the house, it's kind of been like a little, like house arrest, like jail a little bit. So what I started was I started reading some more, you know?
I love that. I love that. Knowledge is power. And I'm actually happy you brought that up because, like I told, you know, everybody who's in here earlier, I really want to motivate and inspire people. And that's outside of just what's popping, you know, in the music scene, what's happening on TikTok and so forth. That's also what's happening in our mind. So what's your favorite book you've read so far or author? Who are you feeling right now?
Right now I'm reading Rich Dad, Poor Dad. I know that's like the that's like the beginner's book for
like
people getting money. But I'm on it now. I'm learning a lot. It's making me look at my money and how I spend it and use it differently. I love it.
Yeah, I was about to say, look, it's never too late to start. Rich Dad, Poor Dad, Think and Grow Rich. I'm definitely hip. And I think it's actually important that you're bringing this up because, you know, our people, black people, sometimes have, you know, money issues. We love to spend, but we got to keep some of that in. You know, I'm all about Nipsey, all money in. Rest in peace, Nipsey Hussle. Now, what's kind of one financial tip that you can give to everybody who's watching right now?
Don't be scared to spend your money to make more money. A lot of times, I know me personally, there's always been situations or things I could do to like make little flips here and there, but I'd be like, I don't know, maybe it might not work out. Or sometimes I'm a little hesitant to take the risk, but you know, what I've learned, I've kind of gotten into, you know, more using my money to make money. So what I've learned is when you take these risks, you either gain what you're supposed to gain or you learn for the next time.
Facts. So it's never a loss. It's just a lesson, right?
Yeah.
And look, I'm all for that. Like, make your money work for you. Y'all be surprised. You put $5 away, that thing's going to go to 10, 15, 20. Next thing you know, you got a couple bands in your account because of you investing in yourself, for sure.
Get you a good Robin Hood account.
Yes.
Start playing around.
Yes, exactly. Look, you all up in stocks too nowadays. I see you. Look at this. This is the
I'm adulting, man.
I love it at its finest. Now, like we talked about earlier, you know, nighttime's your thing. Totally understand that as an artist and as a creative, we're up all hours of the night. Sometimes we still got to get up the next morning, but it never stops for us, right? What changes are you seeing right now, though, within the music industry? Because your world's literally been flipped upside down with not being able to have concerts and so forth. So how are you adapting? Are you doing live events? What's kind of happening in your world?
You know, the music industry is shifting more towards like a lot of social media, utilizing YouTube and your Triller and TikTok and, you know, all of that sort of thing. So, you know, what I've personally done, I've done a couple, you know, live things in the house. I did one for MTV. I got on their IG Live.
I love
and did
that.
a short live performance for them. I did an in-house performance with the Roots not too long ago, but you know, you kind of just gotta find different ways to perform and still be creative. But a lot of it has just been through social media.
Right. And to make that money too on top of that, still find, you know, the income for sure. Let's talk about your latest EP, What You Doing After, WID After. What was the inspiration behind the title?
Being in DC has, I would say, the most liveliest of nightlife scenes in the U.S. And, you know, I've been to Vegas, New York, everywhere. And there's nowhere I've been that has like a nightlife scene where Sunday through Saturday, somewhere is popping.
Facts.
Like popping like Drake is there. Popping. You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
And it's been like that since I was very young. When I was like 16, 17, going, standing outside of Love Nightclub, you know, chasing the women on the way out.
Because I couldn't get in. Look, shout out to Mark Barnes for that plug right there.
Yeah, I used to do that. So I've been coming to the city and I've been a part of the nightlife scene for, you know, as long as I can remember. Mm-hmm. So that project, I'm just kind of speaking on that. You know, what you're doing after is kind of like when I go out, usually if the night is going to get more interesting or not, is usually after I've been asked what you're doing after. So that was the inspiration.
I love that. Because let's talk about it. At least in the D.C. area, you know, it's lit, but the clubs close kind of early. And the let-out's more lit than sometimes the clubs.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Now, you know what I love about you as an artist? You're very diverse in your sound and your lyrics and actually who you have on your project. So I love the features that you had on that EP in particular with Trevor Jackson and Wale. What's one artist that you would love to collab with next that you haven't collabed with?
Man. Pharrell.
Ooh, taking it down to Pharrell. VA.
Yeah, and you know, I got a chance to meet him in November. I was out in Miami with Wale, helping him with some of his stuff. Mm-hmm. And, you know, P, they booked a studio session with Pharrell. Mm. And I had the pleasure to be in the room for that. And also, you know, having a short conversation with him. And he was like, yo, whenever you're ready. So.
Ooh, we're managing that. Coming soon.
Yeah, so we'll see what happens with that. I know it's a big music industry and he's a busy man, so we'll see. But
look, we'll give it up to God for that one. Please help my homeboy out. Okay, thank you in advance.
One more. Another one. Snow Allegra.
I love Snow Allegra. Yes. Let's talk about it right quick. Have you met her?
No.
Okay. That would be fire right there. Her music's so sultry. Yeah. I could see you guys having a good vibe.
She got like a real elegant voice.
Definitely. Like you could play that in your house. You could play it at a wedding as well. You could play it even in your cookout, you know, when you're cleaning and so forth. That's actually what led to my next question, Phil. How do you get into the zone, the vibe when you write and when you create music, Ade?
It's all moods. I'm the type of guy, I let whatever beat I'm doing, I let that kind of take the lead. Mm. If I'm feeling like, if it's like a rainy day and I'm feeling laid back, you might get a song with just no drums and just guitars or like just strings and just something that just sounds very relaxed. If I'm just coming from the club or something, you're going to get something a little ratchet.
Like replacement.
But it's all based on my mood.
Do you play any instruments?
I did when I was younger. Man, my parents tried to get me to play everything.
Like
what? And I wish I would have stuck with some of them. Like I played I started the piano when I was like 5, didn't stick with that. The guitar, the saxophone, you know, I kind of did all of those in like middle school and then I just stopped.
Now, I do have to say, playing music and learning how to, you know, play the keys and so forth really helps you in different areas. I can definitely relate to that for sure. Mm-hmm. I play the clarinet, and I wish I knew how to play the piano or even be able to read music nowadays for sure. Yeah. And, you know, that's what's so interesting about being an artist. Everybody's different, and how they create is very unique to who that person is. And the music industry is not an easy industry as well to navigate through. What's some advice that you would give to an up-and-coming artist who's looking to get into the game?
Look, patience.
We getting deep. We gotta let the people know.
You gotta have patience. It's hard. To me, I don't see as hard as other people might see it, because I love doing it. I love making music. And you know, this was my dream to do this song. Like I'm enjoying it. So I would definitely say, be sure you have a passion for music and that you love it. That's the main thing, because then everything else will fall in behind that, and you're going to do what you have to do to get to where you need to be.
That's real. And that hard work,
I love it.
That dedication pays off, because I literally, you may not remember me, but I remember seeing you back in the day at Radio 1 when I was just a little intern, and you was all up and down the hallways, making sure your music was getting paid, making sure that people knew who you were. Looking back at Ade even 5 years ago from now, what's some advice that you would give him, some lessons that you've learned?
This be sounding cliche, but go with your gut. Go with what feels right to you. I feel like there's a lot of opportunities I miss because I sometimes will overanalyze or be like, this is not ready yet, or I shouldn't do this yet, and you kind of miss waves with that.
That's real. Because as creatives and artists, you know, we're sensitive about our shit. We want to make sure it's all the way tight and right. But sometimes we got to loosen up and live in the moment.
You got to let stuff go, man. You got to keep shooting.
Facts. Now, what's happening nowadays? We got some new music, new projects in the works.
Yep. I'm working on another project now. Yes. I don't want to get too much on it, but there are some heavy hitters that are on there.
Wait, you got to spill the tea. Give me at least one artist. Yes, right here, right now, y'all, on As the World Spins. I'm about to get that exclusive.
I'll say this. They're from the South, and they live in Atlanta.
Bruh, that ain't fair.
That's it. That's one.
And it's not Lil Baby? And it's not Lil Baby?
Not Lil Baby.
Okay. Now, what's kind of the sounds that we're going to hear with this? A lot of hip-hop, we're going to get a little R&B. What are we going to get from you?
My last project, I feel like, was a little darker, on the darker side, a little more moody. This one, I wanted to sound more bright and summer-like. So
I like that.
Get some of that, and it's a little more, I would say, laid back.
Okay, yeah. We're getting some chill all day. Maybe that's the pandemic too, just allowing us to slow down a little bit and kind of be present and in ourselves. So can you like give me like a line or like a verse or two that we may hear on this new project?
I don't have all the final track listings, but I give you some.
Give me something, anything.
I'm just trying to do what makes me happy, living my truth. We was cut from a different cloth, played by different rules. Had to find our way to beat the status quo, still with the static though. Play the corner like Avante Maddox, where the addicts go. Wasn't my habits though. I was on a different wave, played the sidekick to get it, did the Scottie Pippen phase. These are different days. I play it like LeBron on business calls. They say I got a white side. This ain't Hassan. Nah, this is educated black playing with me, get you smacked. For a while, been on these Cubans sipping Azul, but my energy still miles with the yak. I'm sharp as Shannon, you skip because you skipping facts. Still tip my hat to anybody black that came from out the hood, got their old family living good from off a rap, because we don't get as many options to live as opulent. Bar Harbor Shop, take the crew to Nobu, our Fountain Blue occupants. That's a long way from Briggs Cheney. Well, rolling up Bush was my vice like Dick Cheney. We was living insanely. For that money I couldn't attain, my mama couldn't tame me. But she get it now. I count up on the kitchen counter. 2,000, 3,004. Had to fix her kitchen floor. Gave her 3,000 more. Feels good to step up, make up what she can't afford in this cold world that's keeping me warm. Yes, Lord.
Oh, my goodness. Yeah. I got the chills. Look, all y'all watching right now, put them flame emojis in that chat, because that shit right there was fire. And also the lyrics, I can relate to you, bruh. You know what I hate? Like, I hate when people are like, you're not black because you talk like this, or like, because you're from this area and so forth. Yeah, like, black people are from all different spaces, places, and kind. And I just want us all to come together. And I'm so happy that you're really pushing people forward to get that. Like, look, I'm black. That's the color of my skin. End of the end. Because my parents made a better way for me, that don't make me any less black than the next person next to me. We all can relate. We all going through something. And, hearing that verse, I can already imagine what this next project's going to sound like. Because that shit right there, bro, was fire.
Thank you.
Now, music and your music aside, who's on your playlist right now? Who are you currently listening to a lot right now or finding inspiration from outside of Snow and so forth?
I listen to a lot of artists from here. My brothers, Flex Cartel and Bix Cooley, you know, they just dropped some music. So I'm listening to that. That's in heavy rotation. Then Internet James, I don't know if you're familiar with him.
Yes, yes.
He's from Maryland. Mm-hmm. He got some stuff. You know, he sent me a private link to some stuff he got coming out.
Oh.
I'm in love with that.
We may have to have him on the show.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
I love that. So you repping the home team on the playlist right now.
Yeah, for sure.
Now, I have a segment called Litty or Shitty. You got to let me know real quick. What, is this some, you know, is it lit or is it some shit? So I had Reroute by Rowdy Rebel. Okay. I had Reroute by Rowdy Rebel on the playlist. What you think about him?
It's lit.
Okay. What about Coi Leray?
It's lit again.
Okay. And then.
In that, ooh.
Hey.
I'm not even sure what she's saying, but it's just saying.
Now, do you think she sounds like Dej Loaf, though? That's the only thing, bruh. That's the only thing. I'm like, I don't know. People are thinking that. But what do you think about that when artists sound like one another? Are they copying? Is it inspiration?
You know, it happens. Sometimes people get wrapped up in listening to one or two artists, and then subconsciously stuff that comes out of them. You know, what comes out of your mouth is what you put in your brain. So if you keep playing whoever or Lil Baby or whoever, you're going to sound like Lil Baby without even trying.
So, exactly. That's so true. It's just the inspiration behind it, really.
Yeah. I would say my suggestion for that is maybe try to listen to older stuff or some stuff from a different era. But also, I do feel like, you know, we would have missed out on a lot of good music.
That's true.
These people didn't sound like this.
Look, and it's just the greats. At the end of the day, that's what they're supposed to do, help the next person get to where they are. Before we get out of here, Phil, because I appreciate your time, I got to ask you some rapid-fire questions right quick. Are you ready? We got to toast to it before we begin, though.
I'm ready. Let's
okay. go. Okay. If you could have one superpower, what would it be?
I'd be bulletproof.
Ooh, cheers to that. Okay, this one's for DC right here. Ooze and Oz or Ben's Chili Bowl? Now, for those who don't know, Ooze and Oz is that soul food, that, you know, fried catfish, so forth. Ben's Chili Bowl is all about the dogs and the chili dogs. So which one you going for?
I'm going to go Ooze and Oz.
Okay.
Less time in the restroom.
I love it. That's so real. Yeah. Now, if a movie was made of your life, what genre would it be in? And who would play you? Who would you want to play you?
It would definitely be a comedy. Yeah. I think Lakeith Stanfield could play me.
Okay. Mm-hmm. That's different. I like that. Yeah. I rock with that. Now, I got to do this for the ladies. Do you like your women in heels or sneakers?
It's a hard one.
Ooh.
See, now, I love, like, when a woman has her taking care of her feet and it, like, her, like it's a work of art when it's sitting
Facts.
In the heel.
Look, I and love it takes time.
But, you know, them heels can't go everywhere. And I'm all over the place. You know, we go to a basketball game and go to a dinner. Then I might have to go with sneakers on this one.
Oh, you going to judge her, though, if her sneaker game ain't fire? Are you going to help her out?
I'm not going to judge. I mean, if she wearing something crazy, you know, your know, shoes look like they came out the clearance rack at Marshall's, I'm going to look at you a little sideways. But if I care about you, I'm going to help you get yourself together too. So.
Okay, I like that. Building one another up for sure. Yeah. Now, Ade, I appreciate your time. And before we get out of here, where can people follow you, keep up with you, plug yourself right quick?
Ade in my life on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook. Ade in my life. That's ADEINMYLIFE. And
new music on the way.
On iTunes.
Yeah.
ADE with the little accent
apostrophe. Mark. I love it. Thank you so much, Ade, for your time. Thank you for stepping into my world. This is literally, this is huge, Ade, okay? We putting on for the city right now, DMV. We got this show on lock. I appreciate you for being my first guest. Oh, my goodness. And Ade, you got to tell the people if they got the stories that they want to hear, music, if it's lit or if it's some shit, don't let me put you up in that playlist.
Just want to give a big toast up to Remy Martin for always providing the good vibes. Cheers.
Cheers, y'all. I'll see you next time.